to Bankina, the local spot, you know, for a swim. It's gonna be 25 degrees today.
22, honey.
Okay. but 22, and it's gonna be like super sunny today, and then for the rest of the next week, it's gonna be like just rain again.
A lot of people, right?
Yeah, a lot of people. Much more than expected, actually.
Yeah, because I saw some pictures the other day. This is the last day, so it's the third day today.
Yeah.
With my guy, David. Enjoying his sandwich, right?
No.
So we're at your place right now. Downtown Copenhagen.
Downtown.
You like it here?
Love it. Still settling in. Mm. I mean,
you literally live the like most central place you can live here.
Is it?
Yeah.
Yeah, I mean, like, it gets quite crowded like during the weekend.
Yeah.
But it's cool, like, you can just like walk anywhere.
There's a bar, like, very popular bar just up
there. Oh, yeah, that's true. That's true.
Like a restaurant.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
You can see life.
Oh, yeah. So this is like, you can see the streets down here, and this is the bar down here. Just, yeah, this is like very center place.
Mm-hmm.
Jeez! Fire.
Oof.
Actually super fire.
It's super actually comfy actually.
Yeah.
Comfy check.
Comfy check, 10 out of 10. No cap.
And the poof as well, I kind of like it.
It's actually really good.
You know the brand, like, for the candle? Like, the third one, not by Redo, the other one?
Yeah. This one?
Yeah.
Bougie?
Madeleine. Super nice brand, like, they're from Paris. They get, like, a store in Japan as well. Not my favorite, like...
It's blade. Pretty cool with this, like...
Indeed. Like, this
that's
super
actually
cool.
Super fire.
It's super cool. It's just like not my favorite. It's like thick noir, very like sweet.
Yeah, it's very sweet.
So there are people. There are people reselling those.
Yeah.
What are like,
people? Seriously?
Yeah, 100%. But like they're on sale at the store for like, I don't know, 3-5 euros. Like.
Do you remember like the Sanorang condom?
Oh yeah, I had them.
You had them?
Yeah, I had
them.
Did
you use them?
100%. Let me see. I should like.
Oh, shit, you have it.
Yeah.
I see.
Still eating my sandwich, but.
Shit, send around condoms.
I don't know what actually.
You know if you know, right? That's really like you know if you know.
Only for special occasion. Imagine actually like pulling out like first day. So
bro, that's a flex. That's a flex, you know. But that should be like special, I would say.
Yeah, 100%.
That's fine. Really Paris.
Paris vibes.
Exactly. But it's actually Italian, the designer.
It's a pretty fine mirror. Going to Louisiana, you know, just gonna get some gasoline on, and then it's a quite of a ride, you know, 30 minutes.
Copenhagen.
Yeah. So your first time.
Yeah. Have you been there?
So
often?
Yeah, many times.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, many times. It's like I've been going all my life, so really iconic place. So.
Is there anything particular going on today? Is there anything particular going on today?
I'm not sure actually.
Okay.
I'm not sure. But
let's
see.
Figure it out.
Always something interesting up there. What do you think? It's good?
Like, yeah, I like it. I like it a lot. This is like, it's like lemon in it. Like, better than Sprite, but like with lemon in it.
So, what would you rate it from 1 to 10?
Oh, solid.
Solid?
8.
8? Oh, shit.
That's good.
Like, on the soda scales. We're talking like soda scales.
So Mass and David is basically signing up, getting the membership here to Louisiana.
So now let's take a walk in the garden. Mm-hmm.
We didn't do that last time.
No, we didn't because it was
of the weather.
Pouring rain.
Yeah.
And it could pour rain like in 5 minutes, so we should just like do it.
Where right? was last time?
So beautiful the garden, you know. It's good vibes. Yeah.
It's like on top of that.
It's beautiful.
Mm.
Even
let's see what it is. So good. I got 41 though. I wanted initially size 42, but this is what was available, so I hope I can fit these. So the vintage leather Rick Vans is what they call them, with the iconic tote bag with the tonal embroidery here, Rick, the cream laces, and the like a bit cream yellowing sole.
Det er fuldstændig samme,
yeah.
Som vi fik det her skinnet her, sætte det på. Men til start med, så har jeg fjernet helt forsåling her,
mm.
Og tog alle de her
Mine har gået masser af. Let's get it. See if it's here. Oh yeah, he's here. Running a bit late again, so.
Altså min ven.
What's up, man? You're going to the stew with Alyx.
Yeah.
And shooting your stuff, right?
Yeah. From and a new model this time. Not so, myself.
Not yourself.
No.
So let's see.
Let's see.
Gonna help out.
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Appreciate it.
I bought this vintage tee from
Hawaii. Iron Man.
Yeah.
From what year was it?
90, I think.
What?
90.
90. Okay.
Let me check. So this is from a shop called the Kissing Boot, which actually sells really nice vintage clothing.
Yeah.
Pretty cool branding also.
It literally have like the same kind of fade as the hoodie, the drawstring hoodie.
Yeah.
Like the grayish brown one. It's a bit same vibe, but
yeah.
Looks fire.
Yeah. Super dope.
You thought it was more like gray, right?
Yeah, actually I thought it was, but it's okay, like it's
yeah, I think it's fire.
Off white. Rest in peace, Virgil. Tattoo.
Nice.
Nice fit, right?
Yeah.
Feels nice.
Looks good. Could even be sick inside out, I think.
In what?
Inside out.
Yeah, I think so too. Maybe even better.
Yeah.
Actually. I like the print, but
I'm not really sure about the print, the colors of the print.
No, but it's there's so much fade in it that yeah. It's not like popping.
No, for sure.
Yeah.
Sorry.
Like all the ripping here.
Here we are, so finally going to Switzerland to actually this guy I have been, he has been on a few videos now. He lives in Switzerland, one of my good friends in Geneva. So Frederick, so we're gonna go just for the weekend and a hike and maybe go out for dinner and just enjoy like the summer finally here. So just heading into that hall right now. Take care, guys.
Telling you a pussy. Spin a block twice like it ain't nowhere to park. Smack the back side of his head like he bark. OVO for well, we come out when it get dark. Big stepper, he came in a rose, but he left in a stretcher.
Yeah,
my brother.
Yeah.
This is
Fuck you.
Bonsoir.
Bonsoir. Ça va?
Et toi?
On the way to pick up the car. Then we're gonna drive like 3 hours to the spot where we're gonna hike, and then we're gonna hike, obviously. Looking really forward, actually. Got a bit of a cold, a bit. How do you say, you can hear my voice.
I really care for the environment, so we're gonna do all electric.
Okay, just a quick stop, you know. Gotta get the Rebella. For the Rebella boys, you know. The Swiss fan.
So just like, it's made out of like a protein. what's the name of the protein from the
man? I think it's made from like some kind of milk.
Where
are we going?
We are on our way to Oceanese.
Oceanese.
Yeah,
right?
True.
I'm not sure how to pronounce.
Not too real well in pronouncing this name.
So it's like.
It's very close to Kandersteg. Steak.
And then we're gonna go for a hike for how many hours?
Just gonna go up there for a few hours, eh?
Brought out the Oakleys, right? For the occasion.
Only for this. I stop it. You just go, this the finale.
My pep top turned into a pep poly. Say she from the hood, but she. Alright, so finally going up to what was it called again? Mountain?
Oceanese.
So we're gonna go up here with the gondola, and looks pretty sick actually. And then the weather is beautiful, so. Let's get it, you know. Looks promising, I would say. My first hike in a long time, actually.
When did you last hike?
That was like 5 years ago, so I'm excited. Any lake hard girls? All right, so finally arrived at the lake here in at the hiking spot. I forget about the name all the time, but pretty sick, right? Did you hear that? So my friend already a bit tired of me filming, but I just wanted to show this because I think it's actually really, really. So just hiking down this pretty steep road. It actually looked most steep, I think, in the real life. Maybe gonna take a swim in this super pure water.
Go about those sneakers. Let's go.
Get sneakers, right? So actually we initially want to go a bit up, and then not all the way up because that takes a long time, but definitely something.
Time did a fun shoulder.
An exclusive food review from Switzerland, like very exclusive. This Tagaria place. So let's try, this is the chicken, right? It's the chicken. By the way, pull up the summer shirt, you know?
Where's this from?
It's like Italian linen, you know. Gotta get that.
So, okay, taste it.
So let's compare this with the place in Copenhagen. I would give it like 6.5. I think the one in Copenhagen is a bit better, but it's really good too.
Talk about what's trending, what's timeless.
Yeah.
So what particular pieces is trending right now, and what pieces and brands, is timeless, right?
Yeah.
So for instance, just as a quick example, like the Converse, Chuck Taylor, versus something like the Balenciaga Crocs.
Yeah.
You can obviously like guess which one is is the trend and which one is the timeless piece, but we gotta talk something about like that, right?
Yeah.
So that's
the plan for today.
That's like the main topic for today.
For the video.
For the video.
Yeah.
Maybe the title, you know, gotta spice it up a bit.
Yeah.
For the algorithm.
Yeah, for sure.
So
you're going to stay with the 2 weeks.
Upload 2 weeks.
How do you think it's better?
I think
it's better for you, right?
It's better for, I feel like there's more space to be creative in sort of creating new designs.
Mm-hmm.
first thing that we're gonna talk about is obviously the Balenciaga Crocs. Definitely a trend, right?
For sure a trend, yeah.
Definitely.
But a nice trend. I like it.
It's
actually,
it's a vibe though.
Yeah.
I think this kind of shoe is like, even you think it's fire, otherwise you think it's like the worst.
Yeah.
It's like really divides the...
It's the yay boots, right?
The yay boots, right? The but, new yay boots.
But yeah, these are pretty hard to pull off, I think. But if you manage to pull them off, I think you can make a great fit. I saw a Kyron do like one fit with the big
Owens
pants.
That was actually really
actually so fire.
Again, you have to have a certain kind of pants.
Yeah, really baggy pants.
Really baggy pants to make them look, I don't know, fire, right?
I only have like 3 pants I can wear with these.
Do you remember when you got them?
Yeah.
It was like that we had like the normal, Levi's, right?
Yeah.
Like a bit more fitted, and then you have the like the shoe on top of that.
Mm.
So right now I think it has changed a bit. So now people styling them on top, right? So you cannot see the whole boot, right?
Yeah.
I think that's
like the pant out.
Yeah. I think that's more versatile, and
I think that's much more clean.
Yeah, for sure.
That was how I intended to wear them, but I didn't have any pants to start with.
No.
So I only have the Arc'teryx. What do you think about? Do you think this is a trend?
To be honest,
I think these are not as trendy as the other ones. And these are also. These are all from a shoot, therefore. All these now. These, I think, are the most like versatile ones. And these are going to be like a timeless shoe. Yeah.
What else do we have for shoes that is like super timeless, you think?
Converse. 70s.
Yeah.
Super timeless, I would say.
Yeah, but besides that?
Besides that, Air Force One.
Air Force One, yeah, for sure.
That's really timeless.
A classic white. All black.
Yeah,
I would wear black now. Ones.
I kind of want to say the H&M Derbies, but they're like timeless in my head. But maybe someday they're not.
Yeah, they have the platform, you know. So that's a bit of a trend.
Yeah.
But like the Derby shoe itself is of course timeless.
Yeah.
If you have the Dr. Martens, maybe like
Dr. Martens is timeless, right?
Yeah, exactly. So actually, you kind of right in the like people wear a bit more chunky in the winter because people wear.
Winter boots.
Well, they wear like Dr. Martens for winter. They have been doing that for a lot of years.
Yeah, moon boots.
So this is like the new, the new wave, right?
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, the fuckboy. So. We talk about timeless and what's trending.
Yeah.
And basically, Chrome Hearts has been there for like.
For a long time.
For a long time, right? Since forever.
Yeah.
So there is like the diehard Chrome Hearts fans that have been buying Chrome Hearts, not wearing anything else than Chrome Hearts for many years, right? But now there's obviously there's this trend, Chrome Hearts trend. So people like, you know, like you said yourself, it's like football wears Chrome Hearts, right?
Yeah.
So, but they wear this kind of merch, which is like this T right here. So obviously you have it because you're a football. So makes sense, right? But then,
So this is like a trend.
This is a trend piece from Chrome Hearts. They know they are successful, so now they're selling a lot of merch.
Yeah.
I think. And then you have this, right?
So already, like I've just been in LA, and everybody was wearing this. Like all fuckboys had this, and when you were like a high class fuckboy, you had the Lamborghini Urus and this.
That's sick. But I feel like. People don't even know the story about. I'm not saying that I know the story, but I
yeah, they don't appreciate the brand as what it is. It's just like hype.
Like the silver like, and all
this. I have something expensive. Kind of vibe.
Exactly.
Yeah.
They just want to show off the brand.
Yeah.
So also like the dagger belt could be some timeless piece, I would say.
Yeah.
Like an archive piece.
Yeah. All these like heavy pieces. Yeah, this is like one of the most iconic pieces. Actually, I don't have the belt for it yet.
No.
But I would say like the silverware pieces are like some of the most classic pieces you can get. Like I would say like almost every silver piece is iconic, timeless pieces.
Even though like the chain
and the pendants and the earrings, like it's also much more expensive than, it costs like double the, maybe just like the small earring like that, it's like double the price of a t-shirt.
Another thing you also know about the merch is that the quality is so bad.
Quality is so bad, yeah.
Compared to the mainline.
They don't even make it themselves, they just buy the cheapest blanks.
Yeah.
Like, actually the old blanks they bought was much better quality. Made in US and heavy.
Sure.
William has like a really, really heavy.
Yeah.
90. So, the Arc'teryx jacket, for sure a trend.
Definitely a trend.
Yeah.
But again, I would say, is also like not diehard fans, but people been wearing this brand forever.
For sure. Yeah.
But right now, super much a trend, man.
Yeah. But like, it's good if you need like a rain jacket. I will have this forever, but it's not gonna be like trend. It's not
this
gonna be like.
Well, right?
Yeah, for sure. But I feel like it's not gonna be like hyped as it is right now, but I feel like you can wear it. It's never gonna go out of style.
No, no way. No.
But it's still a trend. It's like, it's both, best of both worlds. Kind of. Yeah.
Definitely a trend, but a timeless brand, and it's never gonna go out
no.
of like the hiking, you know, community is gonna wear, and for skiing and all, like, you know, like adventure kind of thing.
Yeah.
People gonna wear this because it's obviously it's very functional.
Yeah, for sure. So let's talk about this, not particularly this jacket,
not particularly
like,
jacket.
Bomber jackets.
Bomber jackets in like plain bomber jackets could be like the vintage one I have, the green one.
Yeah.
It could also be like a black one.
Yeah.
Just wait for. We have an airplane landing out here because Mass's place is very close to the airport. So pretty sure about that. Alright, so here it is. Just like a bomber.
Yeah.
It's always gonna stay as a timeless piece,
yeah.
I would say.
Yeah, the silhouette, right?
The silhouette.
Yeah.
Like the MA1 bomber, I think it's like
yeah.
the original silhouette
yeah.
model.
Yeah.
Kind of thing.
But I feel like this is also going to be an iconic piece since I think it's Rav's first show for Prada. So I guess this is always going to be.
And it's like just clean, right? So
yeah,
it's
so clean. And
it could be like
a fit on.
It could be like an archer piece.
Someday, maybe, yeah.
Could be.
Yeah.
Could be. Hard to say always, right?
Yeah. Yeah, but the Alpha Industries, like the MA1.
Exactly,
right?
MA1.
So iconic.
Has been like.
But you need to buy the vintage ones.
Exactly.
The new ones are just
the new
like
ones
made in China.
Trash. Like if you see fucking Top Gun, you know, like the old movie, they wear it and then you see like the new one.
Yeah, yeah.
They have it as well, you know. So it's.
Rest in peace, Lil Key. Fuck a pigeonhole, I'm a night out, it's a different mode. I'ma have to make a pen of six on a pinky toe. Heard you with a shooting guard, just let a nigga know. I